In this section, we will be using simultaneous products to solve many of the problems in this section. Because of this, we need to know what a simultaneous product does. A simultaneous product has two equations with two variables that are multiplied. To solve, we need to divide both by the same factor. Then substitute. In example 1, we see that we have xy equals 72. If we solve for y, we would divide both sides of this equation by x. So now we have y is equal to 72 over x. Now that we know that we have solved for y, we can take the second equation and again solve for y. We do this by dividing both sides by x minus 5. This gives us y plus 2 is equal to 56 over x minus 5. Notice that now the y's are both on the left side. I have not completely isolated y on the left side of this equation, and that's fine. We can leave it just like this. So now, my two equations have been slightly shifted, so y's are on the left, and all my variables that have x in them are on the right-hand side of the equal sign. I now will take y equal to 72 over x, and substitute it in here for this y. So now this will be in place of the y. This gives me 72 over x plus 2 is equal to 56 over x minus 5. As you can see, I've now gotten rid of all my y's. Everything is in terms of x now. My LCD is now x times x minus 5. I'm going to now multiply my LCD through to each term in my equation. And divide out the common factors. When I rewrite this, I get 72 times x minus 5 plus 2 times x minus 5 equals x times 56. Now I'm going to distribute through to drop my parentheses. I'm now going to rewrite this whole thing in order of descending exponents and combine like terms. This gives me 2x squared plus 62x minus 360 equals 56x. Subtracting 56x from both sides I now have 2x squared plus 6x minus 360 equals 0. Now that I have a quadratic equation in descending order of exponents, I can divide everything by the common factor of 2 and then factor. This factors 2x plus 15 and x minus 12. Set my factors equal to 0. And x is now equal to 15, negative 15, and x is equal to 12. It's important that we keep track of each one of these values for x for the next step. So now I'm going to return to the top of the page now that I know what values x are equal to. So we said that x is equal to 15, negative 15, and x is equal to 12. Once I know these two values, I can solve for y, but it's very important that we keep them separate. Way back in previous units, you may recall that if you want to write a coordinate point, it's parentheses and the x value and then the y value. We're going to solve for the first x value to find y, and then we're going to take the other x value and find the other y. So when x equals negative 15, we plug negative 15 into xy equals 72. If I put negative 15 in for x and solve for y, I get negative 24/5. So the coordinate point would be negative 15, comma, negative 24/5. When x is equal to 12, we get 12y is equal to 72, divide by 12, and our other coordinate point is y equal to 72 divided by 12 is 6. So our other coordinate point is 12, comma, 6. It's important to remember that this is the yx value and this is the y value in both. And you must label them this way, and you must keep track of them this way, or you won't end up with the right solution in any one of the problems.